Okay. How many of you have made a decision that has not worked? Be it, okay, there are some hands already up. I didn't even say what decision. Okay. Some decision where maybe selecting your stream, which subject you want to take in school or college. Okay. Or maybe a sport, drama, a hobby, or even going out for a date. Yeah. Which has not worked. Raise your hands. Okay. That's quite a few. And how many of you have taken a decision that has worked? Stand up. Any decision in your life that has worked? Okay. Okay. Okay, that's nice. Thank you. So we all take decisions, okay, every day of our life. And especially in today's world, there are a lot more. Every second, what should I post? What should I like? What should I comment? And you know, every time we check. So decisions, we take decisions every day in our life. And some decisions change our life completely. And some save lives. Do you all remember this? This was 10 years back. Right? January 15, 2009. And it's the miracle on Hudson. A pilot had to land on the Hudson River, okay? And all the 155 people on board survived. He had to take a decision. Do I land? Do I land on the river? Or do I try to reach to the next airport after a bird hit, right? His name was Chesley Bernard Sullenberger, okay? AKA Sully. This was 10 years back. You remember reading this? This was 2 days back, right? We were celebrating our Independence Day. And on August 15, 2019, a Russian jet lands in a field outside Moscow. And now this time, saving all 226 passengers and a crew of 7. Again, a decision made by the pilot and of course his crew and his entire team, Damir Yusupov. Now, if you go back a few years, whether be it Sully or Damir, they made some decisions. When Sully was a young kid, he used to watch the Air Force aircrafts flying over his house. And that's how he developed an interest of taking into flying. He used to build models, aircraft models, right? So that's how Sully developed an interest. He then later on did his flying, joined the US Air Force, and then later the US Airways. But in case of Damir, have you all read about it? This was just day before yesterday. Okay, in case of Damir, till the age of 32, he used to practice law. He was a lawyer. 32, he thought that I want to do something. I mean, maybe this must have been his passion, which I'm not aware of. He decided to take up flying, enrolled himself into a flying school, got into the airline, and then, day before yesterday, again a decision which saved life. So we all take decisions. Each one of us take decisions. And every decision can't be scientifically, analytically managed. Some decisions come from your gut feeling, right? Intuition, right? I've also taken a few decisions, some good and some bad, right? I started playing at a very young age. I was an athlete, but I took up football, wanted to play football. Played for a school that was not, very good at football or no sports. Was in the team, but never played in the first 11. Then went to college, was a science student, wanted to play for the college. So in my 11th and 12th, I couldn't because science student, wanted to study. I was not very good at it. Okay, and then in my FI, I decided I want to play for my college. So, like a typical young college going boy, so, shorts. I picked up my bag and went to the gymkhana. So, the coach there asked me, why didn't you represent the college in the 11th and 12th? I said, no, I couldn't come. So I was rejected. But I didn't give up. So I went on going for training sessions, represented the college. We won the intercollegiate after many years, went on to represent the university, won the Mumbai University zonals after 10 years, played for the top clubs in the country, played for the national team for pre-Olympics. And that's how my life traveled. Okay. Now, before going to the top clubs in India, I went for a scouting trial at one of the top clubs in the league for their junior teams. I was rejected, but I didn't lose hope. I came back, worked hard, and after 3 years, the same team, the senior team from the same club, gave me a contract. So the whole point is, each one of you will have to make a decision, right? And every decision that you make, it's not only about making that decision, is after the decision what you do. You've made a decision, you might fail, but never give up. Okay? And then, I would like to share a couple of decisions that changed my life completely. Okay, when I was playing for FC Cochin, that was the first professional club in the country, we went for an away match to Kolkata, Mohan Bagan. 2 days prior to the match, I got a call on the landline. We didn't have mobiles like you have right now. On the landline saying that my father was serious. He was unwell. I went to the airport. There was no flight at the night. Next morning, I took a flight back to Mumbai. My father was no more. By evening, we finished off the final rites. Evening again, I get a call on my landline from my teammates telling me that you need to come to play because I was a goalkeeper. I was the only player then who used to play as a goalkeeper and as a right fullback. We don't have a goalkeeper, it's a big match. So I spoke to my mother and brother, and I told them, Acha is no more, but I want to go and play. So it was like the same day, that day, I said, I want to go and play. My mother and brother said, okay, it's your decision. Next morning, I take a flight back to Kolkata, go to the hotel, change, back to Salt Lake Stadium, played that match, went back to the airport, came back to Mumbai. Now, this decision that I took was not for fame. No one knows about it. It was not for money, but it was my decision that it's my club. They need me. I have to go. Okay, and I was at my peak that time. And again, I took a decision. I don't know if it was a good or a bad decision, because in those days, money was not big. I wanted to earn a living. So I quit football at my peak. My coaches, my friends told me, don't do this. You are at your peak right now. I said, no, I want to get back, finish my further education, join my brother in his event management company. And I started doing events. A couple of years later, launched my own company, did events for multinationals. And then my life changed in 2013. Again, a decision, right? My mom's friend expired, so I took my mom for the funeral. And after the funeral, the lady who had expired, her son, Lion Sudarshan Nair, he was a Lions Club past district governor, told me that you do events, right? I said, yes. Why don't you do an event? There's a ground at Milan Subway. You've seen that ground? Okay. I said, why don't you do an event there? And this is the time when we were expecting our second child. So it was, I went there. I don't know what happened to me. I said, no, I want to get back to sports. Because somewhere behind, it was there. I want to do sports. I want to use sports as a platform to serve, to do something better. I took it up as a challenge. But trust me, the time when I told my wife, she's expecting, mood swings. Guys, don't try this. And I said, I'm going to close down my company. I'm going to get back to sports. But I convinced her, and I started working on that project. Okay? That's Lions Club of Bombay Willingdon Crescent Charity Trust. Then they started a Sporting Lions Foundation. I'm an honorary CEO there right now. And this is how the ground was in 2013 when I went there. And this is how it is now. Okay? And every profit that is earned from this sports complex is plowed back to the community. So we work with the blind football team. We work with cricket. We work with underprivileged children. We work with the MCGM schools, MCGM school kids, the train-the-trainer programs. In fact, day before yesterday, we launched a huge league wherein around 8,000 municipal school kids will play football. Where we have also a sport for development where every team will have four boys and two girls. So gender equality, girls playing together, right? So each one of you at some point in your life has to take a decision. And it's not only about taking that decision, but knowing two things, which is very important. Okay, a couple of more pictures. Is who you are. Everyone should know who you are, okay? And what you want to do. It's not only about every decision can't be about, you know, okay, 1 + 2 = 3, and this is what I want to do. It might not work. You might decide doing something, but once you decide, do your homework well, and once you decide, then what you need to do is give your 100%, right? Once you decide, you might fail a couple of times. I'm not saying that just go blindly, because some decisions might be wrong. You need to correct it and move on. Maybe decide to do something else. But once you decide, don't give up unless you give your 100%. And when I say 100%, it's not about, when usually do you give 100%? When do you give your 100%? Yes?
When you have interest doing something,
very good. Usually students and everyone do, we give 100% before an interview, before a presentation, before our exams. When I say 100% is every single day. Every single day, if you have decided, every single day what you do, give your 100%. Okay. Now, so I was doing my Sporting Lions Foundation work. At the same time, the Indian Super League came up. From the inception, I was with the Mumbai City Football Club. I had the development grassroots activities. So, I decided to get back to football, get back to sports. Then, about giving my 100%, but also working as a team. So, I had five people who came from different backgrounds, gave them confidence, empowered them, and had trust in them. And we won the best grassroots program 2 times in a row in the Indian Super League. So it's about, if you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, go together, right? And that's important. It's not about only me, myself. It's about, yes, taking that decision, giving 100%, and then working together as a team. And this is something I always believe in, right? You need to be in the driver's seat of your own life, right? You need to be in the driver's seat. You should know what you're doing, right? You should know what you're doing. You should know what you want. This is what I want. And if you don't do that, life will drive you. Thank you.